Hi there, my name is David A. Wheeler, and I'm here to talk about Metamath Proof Explorer as a modern Principia Mathematica. Mathematics has proven much from just a few principles. However, omitted steps and lack of rigor can lead to opaqueness and invalid proofs. For example, Pasch in 1882 identified a missing axiom in Euclid's Elements, one that had not been noticed for over 2,000 years. One work that was designed in part to counter these problems was Whitehead Russell's Principia Mathematica, which really was an extraordinary work. It attempted to describe axioms and inference rules from which all math truths could in principle be proven. Now, Gödel's later incompleteness theorems did show limitations with this approach, and none of them agree on some specific set of axioms and rules. Still, this was an extraordinary achievement. But there are problems with Principia Mathematica. It uses an obsolete dotted notation that very few people use today and most people find hard to read. Some of its axioms are not widely used or accepted. It was built on a concept of a hierarchy of types. Today, most work uses the Zermelo-Frankel set theory with the axiom of choice instead. It doesn't go very far into mathematics. This shouldn't be terribly surprising since it takes volume 2 before it can reach 1 plus 1 equals 2. Navigation is simply not as easy as web pages. And how can we be confident in its proofs? Yes, they were smart, but even smart people make mistakes. Many find rigorous proofs, created with the most basic principles, to be very compelling. But what can be done better? In particular, can we use computers today to help? Currently, computers often can't develop deep mathematical proofs, but computers are excellent at verifying that a claimed proof is correct, given some axioms and rules of inference to use. They can also greatly simplify navigation, simply add hyperlinks. This leads us to Metamath. Metamath is both software and a language for abstract mathematics. It was developed in 1992 by Norman McGill. It's an extremely minimal and stable mechanism. It basically defines a very simple language that lets you state axioms and theorem proofs, and those proofs can build on other proofs. It also includes software that performs proof verification and exposition. All the proof steps use only one rule, substitution. That means that proof steps are not hidden in code at all. Every step is shown. This has some interesting ramifications. Proofs can be followed by even non-mathematicians. All you have to do is learn one rule. And every step can be drilled down to axioms via hyperlinks. The verifier is relatively simple, so it can be easily re-implemented, leading to very high confidence. By re-implementation, we can counter potential implementation errors. This is a lot like having multiple human reviewers. There are at least 13 verifiers that exist for Metamath today. A Python version, for example, has 350 lines of code that includes everything, reading the lines, everything. There's one in Mathematica that only takes 74 lines. And can be incredibly fast. 28,000 theorems can be verified in 5 seconds in a version of Portable C, or about 1 second in Parallel Rust. This leads us to the Metamath Proof Explorer. The Metamath Proof Explorer, MPE, uses Metamath to define classical mathematical axioms and related definitions. It first starts out by defining classical propositional calculus. Things like modus ponens, implies, not, biconditional, and or constant true, constant false. But those are only about truth and falsehood. It then includes predicate calculus, which lets us talk about objects, things like equality, for all, there exists. And those two parts can be called logic. But logic can only prove truths from other truths. We need to have something to talk about. That leads us to Z of C set theory, which defines the axioms for sets that are typically used today. It also includes the Tarski-Grothendieck axiom. This is useful for some portions of category theory. You could, in theory, just use those directly, but that can be very unfortunate, difficult to use. So it also includes something called the theory of classes, in particular a class builder's notation. Open brace, why, where, something is true, close brace. A class builder is essentially set builder notation. However, these are actually classes. A class contains zero more sets, but not every class is actually a set. It also includes definitions of common terms and abbreviations, and it proves numbers exist from the axioms. This is proved as theorems based on Dedekind cuts, and then they're reintroduced as axioms to easily identify when they're used later. MPE has produced a remarkable number of results. As I'm speaking, there are over 28,000 theorems proven, with more being continuously added. This includes a majority of the formalizing 100 theorems list. That's sort of a challenge list for tools for formalizing mathematics. Here's just a sampler of the many, many proofs that are included in the Metamath Proof Explorer. Now, here's some remarkable things about MPE. You can see every step, no exceptions. They're not just hints for a machine or a mathematician to then puzzle through. It shows every step, and every step uses a theorem or axiom. You can just click on the step to see it. It lists all the symbols and axioms that are used via hyperlinks. So once you learn the one rule, you can follow any proof, including all the supporting proofs. MPE is constantly verified by four independently implemented computer verifiers. They've been implemented by four different people in four different programming languages. This provides extremely high confidence that the proofs are correct. There are over 30 contributors that have contributed to MPE. Here's an example of a sample proof. This is the proof that 2 plus 2 is equal to 4. More steps than you're used to, I'm sure, but each one of these is very simple, very straightforward. Let's focus on those first two steps. The first step is justified by a reference to df-2. What is df-2? Well, if you clicked on it, you'd find that's the definition for the symbol 2. In MPE, 2 is defined as 1 plus 1, which seems like a fairly plausible definition of 2 to me. Unsurprisingly, you can use definitions in proofs. And so, in fact, step 1 just refers to an existing definition. Step 2 is justified by a reference to OVEQ2I. What in the world is that? Well, if you clicked on that, you'd find it's another theorem. And this theorem says that if A equals B, then C of A equals C of B. We don't need to see the steps that prove this particular theorem. We're just going to use this theorem to prove other things. It simply says that if A equals B, then if there's some operation F, and its left-hand operation is exactly the same, and its right hands are equal to each other, then the whole expression is equal to each other. But we can't use this theorem unless we can find something to match its hypothesis. Can we? Yes, we can. Step two can refer to step one, which indeed has this form. 2 equals 1 plus 1 does indeed have the form A equals B. That means that we can assign, when we use OVEQ2I this time, A to be 2, and B to be 1 plus 1. But if we do that, then in this use of OVEQ2I, A must be 2, and B must be 1 plus 1 in the result. C and F, however, don't have any other constraints, so they can be whatever we want, subject to certain constraints like syntax or constraints. That means that we can assign the following substitution: A equals 2, B equals 1 plus 1, C equals 2, and F equals plus, producing the result that 2 plus 2 is equal to 2 plus 1 plus 1. This is substitution. Once you master this rule, you can follow every step in every proof, no exceptions. But can math really be formalized? Some think that math formalization is essentially impossible. Wang, for example, says that yes, there is a theory that corresponds to 1,000 plus 2,000 equals 3,000, but it'd be forbiddingly long. McGill notes that although many people have conveyed that the absolute rigor provided by Metamath is some sort of impossible dream, they seem to assume that you have to break down a proof into individual primitive steps. This isn't necessary, it's certainly not how ordinary informal mathematics is done. So there's an invalid hidden assumption. This is a complete formal proof that 1,000 plus 2,000 equals 3,000. It rigorously traces all the way back to set theory and logic axioms, skips absolutely nothing, and has been formally verified by multiple independent verifiers. Thus, this counterexample disproves Wang's claim. So why is formalization realistic in Metamath? There are several reasons. One is that you can break theorems into smaller lemmas and reusable theorems. Over time, those reusable theorems accumulate, which means that each of those reusable theorems provides a higher level step to future theorems. It provides a simple, consistent rule, substitution. Once you learn the rule, you can just keep using it. Hyperlinks enable easy navigation. Not sure why a step is justified? Click on it. Not sure what a symbol means? Click on that symbol in a list of symbols, and you can see what that symbol is all about. There's also a lot of automation available. Simpler steps are now automated by tools. For example, the 1,000 plus 2,000 equals 3,000 theorem I showed earlier was generated completely automatically. In the future, machine learning may provide even more gains, since there's now a database with a large number of steps already shown. That would be an easy starting base for various kinds of machine learning algorithms. And of course, you can combine automation tools. That's already done today in the Metamath community. Here's another proof. This proves that the axioms used counter Russell's paradox. In Russell's paradox, he was concerned about naive set theory, and he asked about the set of all sets that don't contain themselves, and asked, does it contain itself? And the answer under naive set theory was a contradiction. If it does, then it doesn't. If it doesn't, then it does. However, under the ZFC axioms, we can show that the set of all sets that don't contain themselves is, in fact, not a set. ZFC axioms were specifically designed to counter this kind of contradiction. Nevertheless, it's good to see that, in fact, we can rigorously prove this. Substitution is very important, so here are a few comments about it. Constants, which are shown in black, match themselves. Variables are placeholders, and they can be substituted with other expressions of equal type. The types of MPE are as follows: well-formed formula, which are simply a true-false expression, a set variable, which can be substituted with another set variable, and a class variable, which represents a collection of zero more sets. These must be syntactically valid and meet distinct variable provisors, which are automatically checked. For more information about this, see the documentation. To learn more, visit the Metamath Proof Explorer MPE homepage. In particular, take a look at its theorem sampler and theorem list and give you an idea of what's there. Or visit the Metamath homepage. It includes formalizations of other systems and the book that defines this in much more detail. Thank you very much.